The financial services firm Alexander Forbes says more than 40% of Kenyans cannot afford to retire and must continue working. The firm says another 40% rely on family for support. The survey paints a sad picture of Kenya's ability to care for its growing aging population. Mohammed Yusuf reports from Nairobi.
Carrying a 20-litre jerrycan is not easy for this 65-year-old. Dominic Ologi retired 10 years ago after 3 decades in the public and private sector. But he, like millions of other ageing Kenyans, must still work. He has no savings of his own for retirement. He gets $75 a month from his state pension.
During these times, I had a lot of time in my hands. And to supplement what my wife was bringing in, I looked at my environment, what my environment was lacking at that time.
South Africa-based investment firm Alexander Forbes says Kenya has the lowest mandated pension contribution on the continent, just 10% of income. The head of Kenya's Retirement Benefit Authority, Edward Odundo, says workers need to save more.
If you know if you retire, you should be able to get at least 40% of what you used to earn. But if you are getting less than 10%, it shows that you have a big deficit, just even in the basics.
National Social Security covers most Kenyan workers, but the system is plagued by corruption and management issues. Alexander Forbes says nearly half of retired Kenyans depend on family members to survive. For some, that is not a problem.
It's just nurturing in us as human beings to support, also give back to where we came from. Because look at it from this angle. They have taken care of you from since you're young up to now, taking care of you up to school. And so literally it is also socially acceptable or socially moral, if I put it like that, to give back to mom and dad.
For others, it is a burden.
I get it a bit hard because staying here in Nairobi is not cheap. When it comes also to rent and to know you are paying all that pension for, like for me, I pay for 3 people, is not easy.
The World Health Organization says Kenyans are living longer than they did 20 years ago. That, combined with the ongoing population boom in Africa, means the state can expect more pressure to provide for the elderly in years to come. Mohammed Yusuf for VOA News, Nairobi.